Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Honest Gamer channel, where we'll be chronicling every single N64 game. Now before we get into this one, I actually recently discovered that I am actually not the only person doing this. Funny story though, the other person that's doing it pretty much got the idea around when I did. I think he's a few months ahead of me. He lives in the next state over, probably lives like only 2 hours away from me. And he's doing it in the same exact order chronological. So, even though I'm not the only person doing it, I'm one of two, and we're the only ones doing it. So I'm probably going to start linking to his videos. He might link to some of mine. But it's a fun project. We're both going to have fun with it, and this is where it is. So this week, we're going to be racing some jet skis in Wave Race 64. I got this one a couple of years ago. I played a little bit of it, so we'll play some more for you guys right here. Let's get going. Alright guys, so we're going to do some jet ski racing right now. Since it's just a racing game, it's probably going to be a bit of a shorter video, kind of like Mortal Kombat was. What I'm going to do in this one is, I know I'm not doing the stunt mode, because I suck at it. But I will do a couple attempts at championships. I'm just going to go right in, not worry about the warm-ups. As you can see, I have some rather colorful names for the riders. This is actually a used cartridge and I never reset it, so I'll have to forgive that one. Just go with this guy. We'll go with Fucker. I'm not too sure about what settings to tweak and not tweak, so. Welcome to Sunny Beach. I've always been, I know I haven't gotten too much done in this game. Already talking up, it's been a while since I've played it. I like that there's the buoys you have to go around in this. It's not just driving a lap around on the water, like there's an actual kind of some aiming you have to do. And apparently I knocked myself off the jet ski. Alright. One of the things I always really liked about this too is how good the water looks. I've played water racing games on later console generations and the water just looks like complete crap, so to have it, you know, it's not current gen, but it still looks pretty damn good. And as long as I don't miss this corner, I should be doing pretty damn good in this race. Oh, come on! Take it. I'm not expecting to do the best in this one. I've played it a few times before. I've had a lot of fun with this. I've just never really taken the time to kind of go into the custom rider settings and figure out what works, what doesn't work. Probably should, but. Survive without it, I suppose. So that first first course kind of acts like a little training section, just simple little movement. This one's where it starts getting fancy with all these jumps here, and then some actual cornering stuff. Kind of nice too, because you can kind of, you obviously can't actually feel it, but you can kind of sense that, you know, the weight shift of the rider is actually happening. It's not just a simple turn like, you know, you're in a NASCAR racing game or something. So I'm probably going to end up getting eliminated from this one. Maybe I can cheat my way across to a single point. Nope, just missed it. Alright, so we're gonna have to retry that one.
You finished fourth and got 1 point.
Oh, I got 1 point. Alright, so I need 2 points. Okay, I see how it works. I thought it was a race by race points needed to advance. Alright, so I already have the points I need to make it to the next race, so I should be good.
Watch the signal.
I never liked this track because it more kind of tests your reflexes than anything else. Because you can only see so far ahead of you, so it's more of a reaction course. Which, again, I probably hate it because I don't go into the settings for the rider. But I won't be too upset. Oh, I saw one. And you're only allowed to miss so many before you just get disqualified from the race. Which I'm gonna end up missing this one, I don't really care. I'm gonna cut that one because I don't really care. Oh, come on. Don't let me get last. Yeah, I'm just going through on this one, I'm just doing the bare minimum.
You finished third and got 2 points. Move on to the next round.
Welcome to Marine Fortress.
So, I think last place. Yeah. Oh, I never noticed that one before. Down at the bottom right, it tells you where you need to finish to advance. That's kind of cool. It kind of helps you out with what you need to do to keep going. Nope. Thought that was was a ramp for a second. My bad. No, it's the right side. My bad. Excuse me, Mr. Crate. The weights kind of end up affecting you too, because if you end up kind of turning off of one, you end up turning a little bit more. It's either that or I'm just doing that bad. I don't know. But I've always felt like the waves kind of play into the handling as well. Maybe they don't, and I'm just making excuses for how bad I am at this game. Bye. Come on, get up. Up, up, up. There we go. Guys, you actually get to witness my first ever victory in this game. I've never actually been able to manage to win a race before in this, so. Yay, achievement unlocked. I don't suck that bad. And that gives me... how many points? 14, so there's two more races. I don't think I'm going to end up winning the cup.
Welcome to Port Blue.
So I can finish wherever the hell I want to advance from this one. I've seen videos of people playing this stage, especially Derek's more recently, the other person I mentioned going through the N64 game. This one can be a little confusing. And some of the turns aren't very nice as far as where the, like this corner here, where the buoy's placed. Yeah, that's not very friendly. Oh, come on, I was underneath that enough to make it count, I think. But the other corner that can be a little mean is this one. If you take it too tight, you can end up in that area to the right, and it's pretty much just a little dead end. Kind of frustrating if you get stuck in there. Figuring out these controls a little bit better now. I'm getting the hang of this game. Nope, missed that one. No. Okay, good. Back-to-back wins might actually help me out in the championship.
You finished
first and got 7 points. Great race.
Move on to the next round.
So, it looks like... Now, I'm not sure how this is going to work. Because if I win, and Mr. Asshole in first place gets second, then we'll be tied. And this is actually the best I've ever done in this game,
so... Welcome to Southern Island.
I have no clue how a tiebreaker is going to work. So let's find out together. Hopefully I can win. 1, 2, Go. Well, it looks like we're going to be able to find that. Nope, there's that one. Spaced out. This one I like a lot. Again, I've only seen this in videos, but that actually right there, the whale up ahead. It's a really cool feature, you know, to be playing this game, you know, you're just kind of cruising around on a jet ski in the middle of a race, and then a friggin' whale just kind of plops out in front of you. Nope. There goes the championship, I think. Oh, come on. Really? I wasn't even going that fast. Alright, well, I think I've just dashed my own hopes of potentially winning the championship, or at least tying for it. Well, there goes that. I blame the damn whale. It distracted me. Nope, come on. Really? I even coasted across the damn finish line.
Finished fourth. I'm sorry, you've been disqualified.
That's bullshit. I demand a recount. Well, at least it still took a second. Well, since I got a podium finish, I'm gonna see if I manage to unlock the next tournament. And we'll give that one a go. To bask in my podium finish for the championship. Stupid retire. Apparently, I can't skip this part. Alright, challenge the next class. Well, I'm gonna try that. Championship. This will go to hard.
Select your watercraft, please.
Stick with this guy. Okay, so apparently there's spiked mines in this game now. I was not expecting that. I've always just messed around with the normal championship.
waves seem to be a bit stronger in this level too. I was expecting a more difficult buoy pattern too. But it seems to be exactly the same. Yeah, definitely a little bit more wavy in this one. Nope. That really wasn't that close.
Sorry, you didn't accumulate enough points to move on to the next round.
Alright, let's try that one more time.
Come back! Try again!
Restart.
Welcome to Sunny Beach.
I've got to finish third. 3, 2, 1. I think now that I know to look out for those spike mines, should have hopefully been prepared a little bit more. Alright, thank you. Going around the spikes. Wow, that was barely on sand. Come on now. I was gonna say, you better go down too. Jeez. That was a little uncalled for. But you know, it's okay when I do it this way. Jet ski skills aren't good enough for the next class.
Sorry, you didn't accumulate enough points to move on to the next round. Better luck next time.
Thanks for reminding me, asshole. Okay. This will be my last attempt at that class. Sure. I feel like I've gotten a used cartridge from my little child with all the swears in here. Kind of showing off that, ooh, Mom and Dad can't yell at me, haha. Just the vibe I'm getting. Because I did the same damn thing when I was a little kid, so.
point. Move on to the next round.
Welcome to Sunset Bay.
As you can see, I am mediocre at best at this game, so that's why I'm not going to be worried about doing the stunt one, because I don't even try to attempt them in these races, even though there's plenty of them, like this jump right here, where you get plenty of air to do it. Like, let me try. Nope. I don't even know what button controls I use for the tricks. I'm just more worried about not eating water. No, that was my own fault. Maybe it's me. Let's try another one. Nope. Yeah. So, I apologize, but I can't really showcase the stunt competition because I can't even do it, honestly. To do it for this game.
You finished fourth.
So,
I'm sorry, you've been.
All right, so that is Wave Race 64, the fourth game to come out for the Nintendo 64. It's honestly, it's a classic racing game. If you have the console, you have to have this game, especially because it's super cheap nowadays. I think I picked mine up for $3. But it's a lot of fun. It's different than most racing games. You know, it got overshadowed because of Mario Kart, which came out, I think, a couple of months afterwards. But it's worth it. It's a lot of fun. Like I said, the water looks a lot better than some water effects on this console, as well as later consoles. A couple months ago on the blog, I reviewed Jet X2O for the PS2, which is another jet ski racing game, and the water in that one looks worse than this one. There's also a pretty cool cheat code you can do in this game where you can race on a dolphin, but it requires pulling off a certain number of tricks and in the proper order. And as I've mentioned a few times in this video, I suck at the tricks in this game to the point that I just don't even try to do them anymore. I've even forgotten what controls do the tricks, because I tried doing them right off the bat and I just kept flipping and diving into the water the first few times I played this game, so there's no stunt mode in this as far as I'm concerned. But I hear it's a lot of fun if you know what you're doing. I don't, so, again, I ignore it. But yeah, no, to get the dolphin cheat code, you gotta put something in, and then, like I said, pull off the tricks in a certain order, and I've given up on trying. But, like I said, this is a fun little game for the N64. It's dirt cheap nowadays, and it still has its playability 20-something years later, so, again, if you have the console, definitely get this one. It's a fun one to play. I had fun playing it, especially for this video. But I'm going to have even more fun next week, because we'll be playing Wayne Gretzky's 3D Hockey. Now, not only am I a huge hockey nut, I'm a huge Sabres fan, but this is the first hockey game I ever owned as a kid. Technically the second. I will say this is the first one that has the actual NHL teams in them, because the first one that I owned was the original ice hockey on original Nintendo. But this is where my love for hockey really started. It was a combination of this, NHL 99, and going to a Bruins game, ironically. And then I ended up not being a Bruins fan because they lost the first game I went to. So I might be a Bruins fan today if they had won that first game. But instead, I bleed blue and gold for the Sabres. But in this thing, I'll be bleeding black and red for them because it's their old team colors. So, next week we'll be back with some hockey. I'm even going to try to get my buddy Mate in on it with me. He's the one that I do the NHL face-off series with. So hopefully I can get him in on a game for this one. And, yeah, we'll be shooting some pucks next week. So, go race your jet ski. Game on, guys.